They call them QRAs, quick reaction alerts, from the physical sprint to the thrust of takeoff. Within minutes, these NATO fighter jets can intercept or track Russian warplanes. Here's the latest incident. Top left of this cockpit, a Russian fighter jet intercepted off the Romanian coastline. It's close, with no room for mistakes.
Tens of meters would seem quite close to anyone that's uninitiated, but in terms of relative procedures, it's entirely normal to be intercepted at that range.
But for Air Force commanders, there's nothing normal about what's happening.
Probably the most serious incident we've had. I think any time you fly inside a flight information region of another country, not following the norms without a flight plan, then I think it's not the sort of behaviour we'd like to see in the international community in the air.
They're on standby 24/7, and when the alert comes, fast moving is an understatement. When this plane gets airborne, it could fly at up to 28 kilometres a minute. The nearest Russian airbase is less than 280 kilometres away. It's in Crimea, which was illegally annexed by Russia in 2014. That's the main reason for added tension in the Black Sea.
Please change your course. Please change your course to Starbucks.
In June, British naval manoeuvres unrelated to NATO led to a confrontation with Russian forces.
So this is British warship Delta 36. I will continue to follow the internationally recognised Route 90.
And less than a week ago, a Russian military commander said NATO surveillance, including spy planes, had nearly tripled since 2019. Russia sees what NATO calls enhanced air policing in neighbouring states as an escalating threat. And Romania is buying US-built F-16s to upgrade its air force.
Romanian air force start growing and is in a big process of modernization. And we will not finish with F-16. We will continue to develop and to upgrade the Romanian air force.
But as brinkmanship appears to increase, alongside it, there's the danger of one small mistake causing more hostility or even open conflict. Andrew Simmons, Al Jazeera, Constanta in Romania.
Well, Fabrice Poitier is a strategy officer at Rasmussen Global. He joins us live by Skype from Santander in Spain. Why do you think we're seeing these additional patrols and this additional military activity between the two sides?
Well, I think there are two things here. One is there's a general pattern of escalation, especially coming from Russian forces. And this since 2014, since, like your journalist mentioned, when Russia illegally annexed Crimea. However, it's true that over the last few months, and especially this very summer, you see a particularly hot summer. And I think this is because there are some political events looming ahead, which Russia does not like. On Monday, there is the Crimea platform, which is a summit convened by the Ukrainian president with Western heads of states to assert Ukraine's right on the Crimean peninsula. The next day, Ukraine will also be celebrating its Independence Day. And then finally, in the fall, you will have elections, general elections in Russia. And if you look at the past 20 years of Putin's rule, every time you have some elections looming ahead, he likes to do a bit of saber rattling. He likes to increase the pressure to wave the nationalistic flag. So I think this is what we are seeing now.
And but what's the risk of it getting worse then? Because lots more planes flying in the air, nationalistic saber rattling. If someone makes a mistake, is there an appetite to take this any further?
I can't speculate if there is an appetite, but there is clearly an appetite to keep the pressure on from the Russian forces on NATO forces. This is what we have seen with the British warship crossing international water. And this is what we're seeing also with the surveillance aircraft taking off from Romania. And I think Russia will keep on the pressure, will keep on being defiant, and often crossing the line of what is accepted and even of the rules in international behavior, just to kind of make a point that this is our domain, this is our new area of responsibility. But and I think NATO just has to keep on doing what it's doing, which is to assert its presence peacefully, but very clearly, both to show it can defend its allies, including Turkey and Romania and many other coastal countries, as well as it's supporting countries like Ukraine.
But is there NATO's doing what it's doing, but does Russia not feel emboldened, given that what we're seeing in Afghanistan with the retreat of the US and the NATO forces? I mean, the press in China and Russia have had a field day with this, the retreat of the West. Is this adding to Russia's confidence in the area, knowing that they're seeing NATO in the West being booted out of a country, and that gives them more appetite to keep doing what they're doing?
Well, I would not read too literally the propaganda headlines coming from Beijing and Moscow, because the reality is the U.S. withdrawal and the NATO withdrawal from Afghanistan mean practically that then NATO will be able to spend much more of its focus on the real challenge ahead, which is both Russia and China. So if I were Moscow, I would not welcome that withdrawal because it's going to free up some bandwidth both in Washington but also in European capitals to really put the resources and the political focus on where the trouble is, which is, like we're mentioning today, Black Sea and many other regions where Russia and China are pushing the rules and sometimes breaking them.
OK, Fabrice Potier, great to get your thoughts. Thank you so much for joining us from Santander in Spain. We appreciate it.